Hello! Today we're going to talk about saltwater dimmers. In the resistance dimmer video, I mentioned that there was an earlier, more primitive, and more terrifying version. Well, this is it. It's basically just a variable resistor, like we had before, except instead of a big, large ceramic and metal plate, we have a tank of water. Salty water. Because you know what goes great together? Electricity and large amounts of salt water. In more detail, you have your tank of salt water, and then you have two electrodes. You have a fixed one at the bottom of the tank, and then a moving electrode, which is hooked up to your control lever, at the top of the tank. And you raise or lower that moving electrode to change the amount of resistive salt water that the electricity has to pass through. Now, if you remember the resistance dimmer episode, this resistor has to dissipate quite a bit of power when it is dimming a big theater light. On those old ceramic plates, they just heat up, and everything got warm and uncomfortable, but whatever. On this, the water will actually start to evaporate, and so you have to top these up regularly. That was a job that you gave to one of those technicians you didn't like very much. Now, in the resistance dimmer episode, I did have someone ask why the hot was hooked up to the load and the neutral was hooked up to the dimmer. That's how I found our resistance dimmers. I have asked a few people who are old enough to have used these things when they were still, you know, a thing that people used, and they said that that was just how it was always done, so I don't have a good answer yet, but I'm still looking. Now, one common nickname I've heard for these, in fact, pretty much the only nickname I've heard for them, is piss pots, and I've heard two reasons why that is. One, they just smell bad, because they were tubs full of stagnant, boiling salt water with corroding metal in them. Because if there's one thing that salt water loves more than electricity, it's corroding stuff. The other explanation was that technicians in desperate times used to pee in them to top them up. Which, I don't know about you, but that seems like just a really good way to get your gentleman parts shocked. I've also never actually talked with anyone who's done this or seen it happen. They've always just heard from someone that they heard from someone that it happened. So I don't think that actually occurred. I do have a confession. I don't actually have a set of vintage saltwater dimmers to show you. I'm disappointed too. But what I do have is this book from 1967, which has instructions on how to make your own saltwater dimmer. You know, just in case you're ever short on dimmers and just need to build a few extra from a crock pot and some salt water. Sufficient water is placed in the crock to almost touch the top electrode in the highest position. Circuit is turned on, top electrode is lowered to barely touch the water, and common salt is added to the water until lamps in the circuit start to glow. As electrodes are brought closer together, intensity is increased until full brilliance is reached when the electrodes touch. Now, I want to demonstrate this for you. However, I also want to live to see tomorrow, so I will not be using 120 volts in this demonstration. I will be using 12 volts. So I have a 12 volt AC transformer. That's important because if you run DC current through water, it splits the water into hydrogen and oxygen gas, which can then explode, adding just another hazard to this already exciting setup. First, quick safety note. Don't do this at home. This is one of those techniques from the good old days before they actually put, you know, value on human life. All right, let's do the demonstration. I've plugged my transformer in about 20 foot that way and then run zip cord over to the bench to keep the high voltage away from the water. I have my 12 volt lamp. It's an automotive brake light. I have a glass which has my fixed electrode in it, and I have my moving electrode here. I also have some distilled water. Normally this is for the scissor lifts, but I don't think they'll mind if we borrow a little bit. So let us start by just filling this with distilled water. See what happens. Take our fixed electrode and nothing, nothing, nothing. Yeah, distilled water is actually a decent insulator. It's only once you start adding a little salt to it that it starts conducting. So, I have some salt. Let's get started. Just a little bit. Says it should just start to glow when you touch the top of the dimmer. Extreme stirring action. Oh yeah, we're getting a faint glow. Alright. We just put it on the top. Let's zoom in. Alright, I think I have gotten it to just the right salt level. So if I touch the plate to top. Takes a moment, but you can see it starts to glow. And then as I move it down glass, it gets brighter and brighter until we get to full brightness when the plates make contact down at the bottom. Light goes down. Light goes up. Light goes down. We can just, you know, park it at like 50%. So, there we go. Saltwater dimmer. This is another one of those bits of technology I am just really glad we don't use anymore. Anyway, that's all for now, and thank you for watching.